Hello, Oscillator Sync here, and welcome to another video in the series looking at some tips and tricks that you might want to think about using when you're building sounds for the wonderful Korg Monologue. Now, today's trick is born out of a family feud. So as you probably are aware, the Korg Monologue has an older brother called the Minilogue. And the Minilogue is polyphonic, which obviously the Korg is jealous of. But on top of that, it also has a built-in delay circuit, so it can mix in echoes in with its sound. Now, we can't do anything about the polyphony on the Monologue, but maybe, just maybe, we can help it feel a little bit more at home when it comes to that echo issue. So we've got an initialized patch here. What we want to approximate is this idea of an echo sound. So da, 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 da. So an initial sound followed by a number of repeats which get quieter and darker. Okay, so we're going to have to approach this in a couple of different stages. So the first thing we're going to do is get to a point where we've got a sound which starts bright and loud and ends up quiet and dark. And that's pretty straightforward. We can just go over to our envelope generator section here. We make sure that our attack is at zero, so it's an immediate attack. We're going to set it onto this top setting here, which is the sort of the one hit envelope, and we're going to set a delay which we like. So now we have a sound which starts loud and gets quieter. And crucially, for this sort of trick to work, it does it without us having to hold down the key. Okay, so that's loud to quiet. We also want to get bright to dark. So the way we can achieve that quite simply is if we set our filter a little bit darker, and we just increase our intensity knob on the envelope generator, making sure that we're on cutoff mode, and that's going to send the envelope to the cutoff as well, which is going to have the effect of turning the cutoff up at the start of the note and then bringing it back down over the course of the decay. Maybe a little bit more. Great. Okay, so we've got a sound which starts loud and bright and makes its way to quiet and dark. What we want to approximate now is this idea of these repeats. Da, 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 da. So to do that, we're going to turn to our LFO section. Now, we've got a number of different waveforms available to us on the LFO section, but I'm going to go to the sawtooth. So the sawtooth wave starts high and gradually goes low over time, then jumps back up to high and goes low. And I'm going to send that to my cutoff. Okay, so as we turn up the intensity here, I'll just put the rate somewhere. High rate. And we can begin to hear something which approximates a decay, a delay rather, or an echo. Now, this always sounds better with a slightly richer sound behind it, so I'm just going to throw in the other VCO and just detune a bit. It's a fairly convincing delay, maybe give it just a tiny bit of resonance and maybe make it a bit darker to begin with. Great. So one other thing that we need to consider if we're doing this fake delay is that if we use it in a sequence, so if I just playing a little sequence here. Because because it's not a real delay, we're getting some slightly unconvincing sounds there when the LFO isn't totally syncing up to when we're playing the first part of the note. But of course, we can fix that on the monologue quite easily. If we go into edit mode and over into the other settings section, which is the fourth light along, the very first thing that we get is the LFO BPM sync. Now, if we turn this on and try this sequence again. Can't really hear anything because we happen to have synced up the LFO exactly. But if we mess with the rate now, maybe just increase our, rather decrease our decay time a little bit. So we can get a fairly convincing and usable within a sequence delay sound, despite the fact that unlike the minilog, the monologue doesn't have a built-in delay. I hope that was useful, guys. If you enjoyed the video, if you learned something, then please hit that like button, the big thumbs up, and also make sure you click on the subscribe button so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos on the Korg and lots of other synth stuff as well. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you again soon.